I'm Lori Mitchell-Keller, Vice President of Industry Solutions here at Google Cloud. And Jason and Brandon, it's such a pleasure to be with you today. Thanks so much for joining us. So Jason, you are responsible for driving advanced manufacturing initiatives across Ford, one of the biggest auto manufacturers in the world. Can you share with us how your digital transformation journey has been so far?
Yeah, thank you, Lori. Thank you for the opportunity to share the great things that we're doing here at Ford as we embark in the digitization of our manufacturing operations. It truly is an evolution. And this graphic here, I think, it depicts our strategy and our vision here within Ford. At the top right, you see, you know, connected equipment, and that's very traditional in our IoT monitoring, where we connect our assets and gather data around performance and maintenance and send it to the cloud where we can, you know, do analytics with it. But really, there are additional enablers that are coming to fruition in manufacturing and really around connected vehicle. So as Ford, as we shift our portfolio from internal combustion engines and we really drive heavy towards battery electric vehicles, that entire architecture changes. And what used to be we turn the vehicle on at the very end of the process, we now have the opportunity to turn it on at the very beginning of the manufacturing process. And we're really communicating between full-time the facility, the vehicle, and the manufacturing process all at the same time. At the bottom of the page, it's also very important to have a strategy around connected people, right? So we're talking about massive amounts of data that can be collected, and we don't want to overwhelm people with every bit of information. And the method in which we communicate people is different today than it was before. And we want to take that data. The real key is to take the insights and the critical information and provide that to individuals in a more predictive and preventative sense.
Makes sense. I actually have a brand new Mustang Mach-E, and so I'm really super excited about your world-class manufacturing. So Brandon, can you tell us a bit about your vision in terms of working with customers like Ford and partners like Google Cloud?
No, absolutely. Thanks, Lori. So ultimately, our mission is to help our customers stay competitive by enabling them to innovate through new technology. And we do this by accompanying them on their digital transformation journey. And right now, what we're witnessing is a fundamental shift in the way that companies build and deploy technology with their move to the cloud. As a result, we've aligned ourselves with this shift through investments that we've made both in our go-to-market strategy, as well as our capabilities in partnership with Google. Because ultimately, we believe that any digital transformation journey has to start with the data. And Google, being the largest data company in the world, we felt brought unique capabilities in areas of machine learning, artificial intelligence, and data analytics that ultimately help us extract more insights, more information that we then use to build better software and systems for our customers so that they can then deploy and build better services and products for theirs.
So back to you, Jason. You know, Brandon mentioned data. So what role does data and AI play in your strategy?
You know, at a very high level, AI and ML have the ability to take complex problems and solve them really at the edge within a matter of seconds. And really, it's if you look from a math equation defining y equals f of x of dependent and independent variables, we can take massive amount of data and understand that relationship, the weighting of, you know, cause and effect between process parameters. A simple example I like to use really that's pretty prevalent in the industry is AI vision systems, right? We can take 2D or 3D images of a manufacturing process or a product, create a training model and define a good part and a bad part, and then deploy that with an algorithm in a production environment where within a fraction of a second, we can look at a process image and classify it as good or bad. And when we implement that on the shop floor, right, complementary to our people that work in the factory, we're able to achieve, you know, higher levels of quality. And that's one example with images. But if think about the possibility of all the other data sets and what we can do in the manufacturing environment.
So now maybe a question for the both of you. So what are some challenges you've encountered in implementing that intelligent manufacturing and all the initiatives around that? So Jason, do you want to go first?
Yeah, I think the first and foremost is there's a lot of data that's available, right? And I caution in this space that simply that because you can collect data on everything doesn't mean that you should. So start with a very clear problem statement and develop competencies around that. And once you get the system and the platform and the tools in place, you can scale that to other problems, right? And that's really been kind of the forward journey, is start with something that's sizable before you go widespread scale across the entire organization. The second one really important is data cleansing. I would say not all data is clean. So, you know, the collaboration between Google and GFT is taking that data and turning it into meaningful insights. And the third one I'd say most important is this isn't a cut and paste solution. So you really have to engage different parts of the organization that have domain knowledge. So if it's a solution in powertrain, you're going to need to engage the powertrain people. If it's in assembly or if it's in vehicle design, you really need, you know, domain experts engaged in this solution as well.
And Brandon, what about you? What are some challenges you've encountered in implementing intelligent manufacturing initiatives?
Well, I think Jason did a great job kind of summarizing a lot of the challenges that are faced. He's ultimately the one that's on the front lines facing these things every day. But I think just to reiterate the complexities that we've faced traditionally with manufacturers and automotives in the vast ecosystem of software and hardware solutions that are available. To date, it's been difficult, as Jason mentioned, aggregating all that information into a common platform that could then be exposed to surface the insights that companies and operations are looking for to give true insight to their total operational footprint. So until recently, with solutions like MDE and Google Cloud, it's now becoming a lot easier, more affordable to deploy such of these platforms to kind of give that greater insight and view into the operations of the organization.
So let's do another question for both of you. What role did Google Cloud and our partners play in overcoming these challenges?
I think building on a little bit of what Brandon mentioned, right? This is truly a collaboration, and to be successful as a company like Ford and the scale at which we're trying to implement this, you need key strategic partners in that collaboration, right? We're talking just in one initiative alone, right? In a matter of months, we had 500 million points of data. So, you know, elastic cloud storage is very important in that space as you understand, you know, how much data is relevant and where do you house all of that. Common access, you know, as Brandon mentioned, a single point of aggregating that data from multiple sources and through simple visualization tools like Looker really enabled to start to gain insights around that large set of data.
And Brandon, what are your thoughts?
So I guess the most common role that we play in any type of engagement like this is really bridging the gap between the business and the technology. So when it came to deploying MDE with Ford and Jason, our role was really working with the Ford business users to translate their requirements into actionable data points for the Google engineering product team. Once that was done, we were then engaged with analyzing that data and creating the dashboards and visualizations that the Ford business stakeholders ultimately were looking to uncover. On top of that, you know, I think it's getting into the work itself. We were fortunate enough to have collaborated early on in the design and development process with Google of the MDE solution. So it kind of presented us as being a natural fit to work with Ford and deploying that into their environment. And ultimately, I think having that deployed, we saw some quick successes and early wins in the early stages of the project, just through noticing anomalies in the information that we were gathering with Ford that we're able to zero in on and help them change a number of parameters that they'll ultimately give them more accurate readings as to how specific parts of their assembly operations were functioning.
Awesome, thank you. So Jason, what use cases are you implementing using this data?
So yeah, I'd like to share one specific application that we've implemented in a production environment that's on the screen here, and something that conceptually I've been working on since 2004, before the capabilities in cloud computing and edge devices and sensors even existed. But this is really an end-to-end manufacturing process. So we looked in a stamping environment, right? A large production stamping line where we stamp all of the outer panels for our F-150 and transit vehicles. And we are monitoring everything from material inputs, the most significant process parameters, and then taking an image of every part that's produced on this line. So to put this in perspective, this machine runs at 900 parts per hour and produces over 3 million hits per year. So it is really a pretty significant high volume line. Now, in this picture, we have all of the inputs, we have the process parameters and the outputs. And then this goes back to that dependent independent variable relationship that I mentioned earlier. Now that we have this into a cloud environment and using visualization tools and doing the analytics, as we start to weight those factors, we can determine the relationship. And the ultimate goal here that we're embarking on is, we know there's a distribution of and variation in material inputs, and we can control the process parameters. But understanding that relationship, we can essentially hold the output, the quality of the part constant, and respond to any variation in any of the other parameters. That's the ultimate goal.
So Brandon, how did GFT complement this solution?
Again, I think just to reiterate the importance of the partnership and working together to go ultimately farther than what we could do individually, GFT's role, again, bridging the gap between business and technology, applying our vertical domain specific knowledge in automotive and manufacturing, and pairing that with our hands-on implementation experience with Google Cloud Technologies, really assisted in getting this solution to market or into production faster than had we started from scratch. So I think, again, the combinations of having the relationship with customers like Ford, having the partnership and being intimate with the solutions that Google Cloud is investing and deploying to market, ultimately enabled us to work together in a collaborative effort between the three parties to deliver a solution that ultimately proved viable for the business. And that was, again, our ultimate goal and objective in partnering with Google and Ford on this initiative.
Awesome. So, Jason, let's maybe dive a little bit deeper in. Can you help us with the top three insights or results that would help manufacturers on their intelligent manufacturing journey?
I'll give you four. So the first one, I go back to defining the problem statement. And really the importance of that, of framing, you know, how you want to apply the technology and what you're trying to solve. And in this case, what we did around that is, one, when we started to look at data, we validated things that we assumed to be true, right? So if we look in the case of material inputs, the distribution of the range of data fell right within our specifications. So that was kind of a good validation. There was also a learning of things that we didn't understand, right? And that's really quantifying the distribution and the variation of the output. Also, we go from sampling to real-time data collection. You're also going to learn things about the process that are unknown. Throughout this, as we started to look at individual sensor data, we identified, you know, different calibration concerns or correlation concerns that needed to be resolved to have a more robust process. And really, it's, you know, the final recommendation for all manufacturers or anybody implementing a similar strategy is really understand and align your internal organization, and then the importance around collaboration with strategic partners, right? As Brandon said, you know, as we replicate this at scale and with speed, it's important to pick the right partners, such as we've done here with Google and GFT.
Well, Jason and Brandon, thank you so much for your insights today. And certainly thank you so much for being here as well. It was super fun from my side, and I'm sure your insights are going to be so helpful to the many manufacturers out there. So thanks again.